Today, inshallah, we're talking about a hadith that is reported by Jarir bin Abdullah al-Bajali, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And Jarir bin Abdullah al-Bajali, he was one of the Sahaba who became Muslim at the 9th of Hijrah or the 10th of Hijrah in Medina. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And even before he came, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the Sahaba that a one person will come to you. Alayhi mas'hatu malak. He's very looking like the angel. That means he's very beautiful and he's really take care of himself. And subhanAllah, he said before, Jarir bin Abdullah al-Bajali, he said, before I came to Medina, I stopped before Medina. And I took all my travel clothes and I wear another one, beautiful. And wear even the hulla, the suit, and went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he entered the masjid, he found out that everyone turned his face and looked at him. So, right away, he was so smart. He sat beside someone and he asked, what the Prophet said about me? Because he knows, like, if anyone comes to the masjid, not everyone will turn his face and look what. So, when they told him what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, Alhamdulillah, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said like this about him. He compared him to the angel. So subhanAllah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent him to the one of the last idols to remove the idol and ask the people who worship, which is this his tribe and the other tribe, they used to worship this idol, to ask them to be Muslims, and alhamdulillah, they become Muslim after Jarir bin Abdullah al-Bajali. He was a very honorable person in his people. So, he always, when he's talking about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned him in very good words, which tells us how much love that he had to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even when he said, that ما حجبني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وما رآني إلا ضحك. That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم never stopped me ever from seeing him. You know, the kings, the leaders, they have someone who stopped, like, not everyone can go to the leader and see him right away. There is some people between. So he said, I never saw this from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I always go and no one stopped me. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never ever saw me unless he smiled in my face. It doesn't matter what's the situation, he always smiled in my face. So subhanAllah, he was really like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to behave with his companions. And during the fitna between Ali and Muawiyah, he didn't join any group, even though he was a leader of his people. During the time of Umar bin al-Khattab, he appointed him as a leader of all the tribes in his hometown. He became the leader. And even when they tried to let him support one group, he didn't. And he said, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent me to ask people for Islam, he said, if they said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, you are not allowed to fight them. I can't fight anyone say la ilaha illallah. So subhanAllah, he said, I will not join the fitna. I will not fight anyone saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. If there is anyone witness that there is only one God, I will never fight him. And he passed away on the 51 of the Hijrah, after the Hijrah, or 54th of the Hijrah. So between around that year, he passed away. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجمعنا به. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى to put us with him إن شاء الله in Jannah. So he said, بايعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على إقام الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة والنصح لكل مسلم. And in another narration, he said, بايعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على السمع والطاعة فلقنني فيما استطعت والنصح لكل مسلم. So he said that I gave the pledge to the pledge to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, the bay'ah, for establish the prayer and giving the charity, the zakat, and to give the advice to each Muslim. In another narration, he said, I give the pledge to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to listen and obey. And then he taught me to say فِيمَ اسْتَطَعْتِ, like with my capacity, like it's never, like when I can obey, I will obey. So he put this condition, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put for him this condition in his bay'ah, in his pledge. وَالنُّصْحْ لِكُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ, and to give the advice to each Muslim. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he took the pledge from the Sahaba, because usually when they come to be Muslims, they would say, we will give you the pledge to be followers, to follow this religion, but what we should do? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam usually asked them to establish prayer, to do the charity, and this is just a shortening of the obligatory things. That's why the scholars, they said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he only mentioned this, it means like the obligatory things of Islam, the five pillars of Islam. وَالنُّصْحْ لِكُلِّ مُسْلِمٍ, and this is extra, to advise each Muslim. That's why in the other narration he said, جَرِيرُ بْنِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ الْبَجَرِي, السَّمْعُ وَالطَّاعِ, which is to listen to the Prophet and obey, فِيمَ اسْتَطَعْتِ, with his capacity. وَالنُّصْحْ لِكُلْ مُسْلِمٍ. So we know that we should keep the five pillars of Islam. So we will not talk about this. We already talked about the pillars of Islam, about the charity, about the salah. But today I want to talk about وَالنُّصْحْ لِكُلْ مُسْلِمٍ, that to give the advice to each Muslim. This is a thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to take from the Sahaba as a pledge of Islam. Even in Hadith, Ibn Umar, also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned the same thing. With Ubadah bin al-Samit also, he mentioned. So, why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked the Sahaba to give the advice, and how they replied to this pledge during their life? First of all, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith that ad-deenu an-nasiha, that the religion is the advice. The religion of Islam is giving an advice. So this is our religion, because we can't really see our mistakes. Each one can see the mistakes in each other person, but he can't see his own mistakes. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Al-mu'minu mir'atu akhi," that the believer is the mirror for his brother. Because I can't see my mistakes. If I see the mistake, I will correct them. But you can see my mistakes, and you can tell me about the mistake. So if we keep the advice going in our community, in our society, that will develop all Muslims to better and better status in life and in hereafter as well. So Jarir bin Abdullah al-Badali, when he gave the pledge to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Imam al-Nawawi mentioned this story in Sahih Muslim. He said, once he sent his servant to buy a horse for him. And he went to the market, bought the horse, and came to him. And he said, how much you paid for this horse? It's like a very good horse. He said, I paid 400 dirham. He said, do you know where did you bought it from? He said, yes. So, do you know the guy, the owner? He said, yes. He said, idhab fa'tini bih. He said, go and bring him to me. The servant said, oh, what is the wrong with the horse now? Maybe there is something I didn't see. So he went and he asked the guy. He said, I bought the horse for my master and I want you to come. He wants to see you. So when he came, he asked him. He said, did you sell the horse for my servant? He said, yes. He said, are you satisfied with the money that he paid? He said, yes. He said, but your horse worth more than that. Do you accept 500 dirham? He said, yes. He said, but still your horse worth more. What about 600? 700? And then he said 800. He said, like, are you kidding me? He said, no. Your horse worth $800. Dirhams. So he paid to him. And before he leave, he said, come back. There is nothing with me. There is nothing wrong with me. I'm not crazy. There is nothing wrong. But I give the pledge to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give the nasiha, to give the advice for each Muslim. And your horse worth that much. I will never betray you. So let's look in our life now. I wouldn't say, like, let's compare our life to the life of the Sahaba and how they apply. So it's one thing that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't even stay with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for a long time. He just, like, he became Muslim on the 9th or 10th of Hijrah. Almost the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed after. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him a very simple thing. Give the advice. And that's his actions after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he buy, when he sell, when he dealing with people, he always giving the right advice, even though it will affect him. No one will pay like 50% extra just because he gave the pledge to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And now these days, how many pledge that we gave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not even to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How many times we said, oh Allah, we will keep this. And we neglect in our pledges to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sometimes, wallahi, my dear brothers, sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like when you give the pledge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's very important to keep. It's very, very important to keep. There's the story when one guy in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he gave the pledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, give him money, he will spend, and then he didn't even give anything, even the charity. فَعَقَبَهُمْ نِفَاقًا إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يَلْقَوْنَهُ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the nifaq, put the hypocrisy in their hearts to the day when they will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from this guy, he didn't even accept the zakat. You give the pledge to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then you reject, I will never accept anything from you. It's very important when we promise ourselves in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep this. Maybe sometimes we promise Allah, oh Allah, if you give us this, we will do this. Or sometimes if we, oh Allah, I will keep my prayers on time. Oh Allah, I will do. No one asked you to do this. You did it in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You should keep. Otherwise, it's really risky. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put the hypocrisy in your hearts, and then nothing will work with you. That's why they said, with the ma'asi, يُنْكَتُ فِي قَلْبِهِ نُكْتَةٌ سَوْدَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, like with each ma'asi, will put like a dot, small dot, black dot in your heart, until it becomes a lot, so it will cover the whole heart. And then the heart will be sealed. Nothing, no reminder would really affect this heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sealed on. That's why it's very important to keep the promises, to keep the pledge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to act, to remember these pledges and keep them in our life. And the pledge that Jarir bin Abdullah al-Bajali gave to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is very, very important in our life. That's why, as I said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدين النصيحة, the religion is the advice. But the advice, it has conditions and adab. It has manners. Sometimes you try to correct a mistake, but you do a mistake worse than the mistake itself. How many times people, they make mistakes, and then when other people, they try to correct them, they do it in a bad way. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us when we invite to His religion with the hikmah, with the wisdom, with the maw'idha al-hasan, with the good advice, with the manners. Imagine, even with the Fir'aun, the one who said, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى, I'm your greatest Lord. He claimed that he's in a place, he can replace Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Musa and Harun, he asked them to say soft words. Soft, he said. Layyina. So he may remember. That's why they said, there's a guy came to Harun al-Rashid and he tried to give him the advice, but he started yelling, and you do this and you do this. And he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent someone better than you to someone worse than me, and he asked them to say a soft word, which is Musa and Fir'aun. He said, you don't know how to give the advice? Go out. Which is true. So, what is the conditions and the manners to give the advice? First of all, you should know the one that you want to give the advice to. You should know him. Maybe he has no other choice. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, he used to ask, even before give the advice. And this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he saw a Bedouin guy with a very bad clothes in the masjid, he asked him to come, and he said, Is Allah give you like favors, bounties, money? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored me with a lot of money. He said, which kind of money? He said, this money and this money, a lot of things. And he starts mentioning what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. And then Allah, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said with very soft, with very easy words, he said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a favor, then he would like to see his favors on you. That's it. Imagine like if you see someone wearing very bad clothes and you go to him and say, oh, why you wear like this? You can do better than wear good things. Maybe he doesn't have money. This is what he can afford. He can't really go and buy a very nice suit. So you have to know if he has the money or not. And it's not nice to say like, oh, you're wearing very bad. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam give it in very nice. He said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a favor, then he would like to see his favors on you. That's it. Show the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is very, very good way to advise people. Also to choose the right time and place. That's why timing and place is very, very important in nasiha. Imagine if someone or a sheikh in the minbar, he did a mistake, small mistake. Well, now, and you correct him in front of people. It's not nice. Unless he made a mistake, maybe it will affect the other people. They would think it's right. Like he said something like the halal, not the doubtful things. He made the halal haram or the haram halal. That, then you have to make it clear to other people. And you have to give the nasiha between you and between the one who did the mistake. But before you do this, you have to be sure it's a mistake, because a lot of brothers, they start giving advice without knowledge. They don't know if it's a mistake or not. And it happens in the masjid a lot, that people, they come and they said, oh brother, you have to correct this way of salah, you have to do this, you have this iqam is not right, and this adhan, you should do this. But there is a lot of ways to do it. For example, in iqam and Hanafi madhab, you do it just like adhan, twice. In the other madhab, they shorten the iqam to be one. So in adhan you say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. In iqam say, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Then say Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah one time in iqam. Ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah one time. Right? But in Hanafi madhab, it's twice, just like the adhan. And both mentioned in the correct hadith, and both has been done in the time of the Prophet. There is no wrong with it. And I saw people fighting for this. SubhanAllah. And when I mentioned it's both correct, no one of them agree about that. Each one thinks he's the only right person. And he got it right, and the other person is bad. And this is, subhanAllah, I said, from if you have arrogance inside your heart, this will be very difficult to go back. That's why it's very important not to say anything without knowledge. And if you do a mistake, just say, this is a mistake, this is from the shaytan, and I always seek the right, so this is the way of Allah, and you follow it. So, it's very important when you give the nasiha, to have the knowledge first. Imagine if a sick person came and asked about a medicine. No one can give him an advice except a physician, a doctor. Same when someone wants to build a building, he will go to an engineer. No one else can really help him, right? So same thing, even it's in religion, it's even more because it may affect the relation between him and his Lord. Maybe you will make him make mistakes in his salah. And then you will get all the wizard, all the sin for his mistakes. And when you give the advice, you shouldn't think that you are better than him. And this is very, very important, the intention. You do the nasiha, you do the advice for the sake of Allah, because you love your brother and you don't want him to fall in mistakes. Not because you think that you are better than him, not to show off, not to show to other people, oh, I know the mistakes and I can't really point them. This is very important. So when we do the nasiha, when we ask our brothers to correct themselves, is not because we are better than them. And we don't think that we doing them favors, even though it's correct. We doing it as a wajib, as obligatory on us to correct our brothers, and they will correct us as well. So we will all will seek help from each other to be on the right way. So ikhlas, sincerity, is very, very important. And you can't do, or actually when you're sorting the nasiha, you shouldn't lie or cheat in the nasiha. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Al-mu'minu mir'atu akhi, actually this is very, very beautiful words. He said the believer, according to the iman, according to his belief, he is the mirror to his brother. And when he said mirror, there is no exaggerate. Like if you go in front, if you want to fix yourself in front of the mirror, you go, it will show you nothing except what really you are. So it doesn't exaggerate and it doesn't make the error less. And that's how you should act. If you see a mistake, you say, this is a mistake. You don't say, oh, how dare you do this, and this is like... You don't exaggerate. It's a mistake. Point the mistake. Don't exaggerate. And don't make it less. Sometimes, like, you love the person, you really like the person. You say, this is a mistake, but it's okay, you know. No, it's a mistake. If you really like the person, you should ask him to fix the mistake. And then it's up to him to follow the nasiha, to follow the advice or not. But don't make it more, don't make it less. And your friends, if you want to ask people, give them the advice to give a charity, and you never even think about it, no one will listen to you. If you don't pray, don't ask people to pray. Start with yourself. Give the advice to yourself. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنْفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. SubhanAllah. Don't you have minds? Don't you think that you ask people to join the birr, the good, and you don't join yourselves? That's why he said, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. There is no mind. You don't even think. If you think it's good, you should fast and go and do it. So the nasiha, it's very important, and accept the nasiha is very important as well. Now these days, everything is easy. All the ma'asi, all the sins is okay, but you just ask anyone, say ittaqillah, say like fear Allah. You will find people get angry. Even if say, may Allah forgive you. You said, what the sin that I did? Well, I make a dua for you, right? It's a dua, you should accept it. And when you give a nasiha, with the right manners, with the right, with all conditions, you should accept the nasiha. Anyone that someone else give him a nasiha, he should accept it. Actually, Umar bin al-Khattab, he used to say, may Allah be pleased with someone, give me a gift, my mistakes. He said, the mistakes that you point for me, it's a very valuable gift that you give to me. That's how they used to value the nasiha. Because without the nasiha, you can't really correct yourself. You will still doing the mistake for the whole life. You will never be able to fix them. You need the nasiha to fix yourself, to fix the mistake, to correct yourself, to be a better person in life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from those to give the right nasiha to people with the manners, and to accept the nasiha from the others. Do you have any questions? No? Nothing? Okay, we don't have Ali Sajjad today, subhanAllah. He's the only one asking. Yes. Jazakumullah khair.